Detective Robbins, some memories just won't die. KFRY, Country Stereo 102. Bob Mitchell here with your country music on a Thursday. And I would like to remind you now that the Muscular Dystrophy Association is looking for volunteers to help out during the Jerry Lewis Labor Day telethon. If you would like to give them some assistance, call 486-3420.
Hi, Leon. Hi, Anthony.
Hello, Betty.
Hi, Don. I didn't say anything.
Thank you.
way. Jesus Christ is the only way to go. Cleanse your heart, purify your soul. Diggy-liggy-la, diggy-liggy-lo. Turn it around. Diggy-liggy-lo, diggy-liggy-la. Jesus Christ, who would I hide? You can't live even when you die. Diggy-liggy-lo, diggy-liggy-lo. All right. Remember, girls, if some of the macho cool guys are sitting next to you, they be cool to say, yo, poke them, give them a back time, huh? There we go. Ready? One, two, three. Well, diggy, diggy, high, and diggy, diggy, low. Jesus Christ is the only way to go. Cleanse your heart, purify your soul. Diggy, diggy, high, and diggy, diggy, low. Diggy, diggy, low, diggy, diggy, high. Jesus Christ, do the high. You can't live even when you die. Diggy, diggy, low, and diggy, diggy, high. Let's try again. Well, diggy, diggy, high. Do it. He's a miraculous God. Slow down. Bring her in. Out. We're going to get this train started, and it might get a little funky at first, but, you know, it'll turn cowboy later, okay? You ready? Talks about good old America, so it goes like this. I don't have you. statistic, folks, but you better take a look for yourself. America's taking the word of God and put it away on the shelf. Now, I've got news for you, my friends. It's a shaking and it's coming fast. We're going to find out who's really first, who's going to end up last. Well, the kingdom of God is coming, and Jesus is going to run the show. He knows he's doing sheep hop, and the goats have got to go. So, friend, I need to tell you now, it's time to take your stand. Take your stand. Well, the judgment day is coming for every woman and every man. Every woman and every man.
Bad news.
people really just, for example, my roommate is number
three.
What do you say, number three in California, or he's supposedly in America right now on Pac-Man at about 3.5 million. But, you know, he really put his all into the thing. And for him, it was kind of a neat thing because he's hard of hearing and he has a hard time communicating with people. And, you know, it's really tough on him. So I kind of felt like video games were a neat thing for his side, for his time, but he just doesn't enjoy the music, so he doesn't travel with it. And I just think, Lord, what are you going to have to help him? And he's really put his endeavors into really going at it, just like, you know, his goal is to be number one in America on Pac-Man. And there are, you know, other activities. You know, we all get involved in sports. Hey, we get involved in music. But there are just things we can end up fantasizing on, and that's wrong. And I think some of you know what I'm talking about tonight. You've been daydreaming about somebody, and maybe the Lord inside, pulling at you saying, hey, you come to me and ask, and I'll give it to you, and have a hope. But don't dream hour on hour every day about something. It's called fantasy. You're excited. You look thrilled enough. He's the punk rocker of the band. Can't you tell by that? Look at that nice t-shirt he's got on. Does anybody recognize that t-shirt? Had a super time. Had a super time. That's good. You look so excited for getting married in 2 weeks. Totally bored.
Yeah, it's like when somebody dies and it doesn't register, you know, until a few days later. I've been unmarried so long.
Hey, old man. We can relate.
That it's hard to, it's like going to a steakhouse and just savoring, you know, you put a bite of that steak with a juice and the steak sauce in your mouth, you know, and you just savor. You don't want to swallow it because it tastes so good, you know. You just swish it around a little bit and just, you know, you just drink in the taste of it. And that's like, you know, there's I'm just savoring these last couple of weeks until I marry my sweetheart.
Jesus does know. He knows all about us, more than we could ever think. I know that's hard to figure out when there's 4 billion people on this earth. And you sometimes think, oh, wait a minute. How can one man know intimately every person? Isn't that kind of a heavy burden? But yet, he's far above us. And that gets me so excited. Jesus knows all about us. That's the name of the song. You forgot the song? Okay, here we go.
He's been up and he's been down. He's
Okay, it's time for me. Do a sing-along, huh? Remember this one from last Christmas in San Diego? Back on the farm. We'll teach you to. If you don't know it, you listen. If you don't sing along.
I don't want to be a goat.
This time around. Are you ready? Time to go to bed. I said, Dad, come on, please. Let me sleep on the couch downstairs. Let me sleep on the couch. Do all the chores tomorrow. Let me sleep on the couch. Get up there and get into bed. And I'd walk those steps. And I, mind you, was, you know, 13, 14 years old. And I'd go in there and I'd plug this paper into my ears and I'd plug it. Oh, you know, I dreaded it. And somehow I talked my brother into trading rooms finally. And in this old room, we had this heater that crackled all the time. I thought, oh, God, there's noises in here. I won't hear anything. And we finally moved to California. And when we went back that year, the following year, I slept in that room one night. That was the last time I ever slept in that room. And so I forgot about being scared in the dark. 10 years passes, And I'm going up one night to this camp, see? And I'm praying on the way up, oh, Lord, do something in me. You know, bring something out of me that's not too good and clean it away, okay, Lord? That night we get there, and I'm with my friends, this husband and wife, and we go in up to the part of the hotel, and it's a Tuesday night, and there ain't really anybody there, and it's an old hotel. And they say, here's your key, you're in room 223, and here's your key, folks, you're in 272. And I said, wait a minute. Now wait a minute. Why are we so far apart here in rooms? Why can't we be right next door? Maybe be in this, you know, kind of a suite with a door in between? And, you know, the guy just didn't hear me. And my friend said, oh, come on, Ted, you know, don't worry about it. You know, everything's gonna be fine. That night I had to walk down this dark hall to 223. And I got there, and I knew there was no neighbors around, and I went into that room. And gang, let me tell you, suddenly it popped up. The fear that night in that hotel, when we'd talk about fear, he'd say, Ted, don't worry about it. He says, I'm going to live until I die if it kills me. What'd you say? He says, I'm going to live until I die if it kills me. Yeah, you've heard that slang. The wobbler. Get to Hawaii, it kills me. I thought, hey, that's interesting. I'm going to live till I die if it kills me. So we wrote a song entitled, I'm going to live till I die if it kills me.
Kills me, the top prisoner. 'Cause
feet. Some of you remember? If those of you know, don't spill it to the ones that don't know. Huh? For those of you that don't know, who do you think the woman was that was caught smoking in the Bible? Come on. Her name was Rachel. Rachel. Remember the story about Rachel? It clearly states that Rachel lit off her camel.
Did anybody here know, well, guys, did you know? I never win popularity with the girls this way. Guys, did you know that there's not going to be any girls in heaven? Not going to be any women in heaven at all. Because it says in Revelation, hey, that there was silence in heaven for a half hour.
Sing it like you're from Oklahoma. I'm a man. I'm a man. Thank you. same as happened.
Flower.
of neat things planned for all of us. All of us. And it's greater, not the thing, we're boogieing around here on Earth, this is the size of a footstool, and he's got a place set up that's big as a mansion, and we're worried about, I'm going to chance to get married, or get that right job, or that right car, or that right house, or whatever. Hey, don't worry about it. He's got a greater plan, I can guarantee you. A greater plan. This is called Running on Radar, and it talks about when sometimes we don't feel like serving Jesus. Do it by faith. He'll bless you for it.
Well, I was on my way out again. And this day got so fast, well, they moved on it. Well, the feeling is on. It's fate that's tearing me up. Because I'm running on the radar, I'm trusting my Savior, I'm riding on the radar again. My Lord, where have you gone? Is it something that I've said or done? Is it some big sin that's done you wrong? And that's when I hear him say, this old road isn't always paved my way. Let's take you here and into the storm. And we'll work for good. There's things you've got to learn. You won't say more. Stand upon my word, and I'm on your radar again. Them big dark old clouds with him, moved on in, and the feeling's gone. It's fate that carried me on. Because I'm on your radar, trusting my Savior, I'm riding on your radar again.
A loved one. It's all right. Jesus will turn it into good.
Sun is coming out, going
promise me a rose garden, walking this road below. But righteousness, peace and joy, another good things for my soul. Well, I want to be a spiritual man, living right and free. But I know there's a price to pay, and the cross is waiting for me. I said it's all right. It's all right. I want to live to be a holy man. I heard him say, you'll have your wish, but just remember this thing. And then he said, to partake in my joy, you're going to taste some suffering. I said, it's all right. It's all right. Jesus got a hold of my soul, and it's all right. Felt a little bit.
Good thing that spotlight's so bright. No, what I can see in here, you look pretty good. Looks pretty good. A lot of smiling faces out there, and that's what we want to see tonight. The love of Jesus shining forth. It'll be encouragement to Bob, especially to see those smiling faces coming back at him when he comes out about 7:30. One of the distinct pleasures that I have working, oh, by the way, I'm Tim Halsey from KTED, and we'd like to thank you all for coming out tonight. One of the very distinct joys that I have with people that I work with, the Lord has truly blessed FM 97 with some very talented people, people that love the Lord, that are willing to give even beyond that that they're required to give. And this gentleman and the group of people that are with him, well, even though Ted's the only one employed at FM 97, the rest of the band is family too at KTED. And I'll sure be glad when you guys finally come out the record, you know? How about you? Well, we're working on it. This man can take this fiddle, make it talk, make it sing, do just about anything. Every time, Ted, you come out and you play this fiddle, I think of Wayne Watson's song, The Touch of the Master's Hand. Many of us tonight have felt that touch, and just before Ted comes out, would you join me in just a short word of prayer? Father, we thank you for the touch that many of us have felt in our lives. We thank you for the touch that is on Ted and the rest of the members of the band. We thank you for the way that you've touched Bob Larson and you put this very special and unique ministry on his heart. Lord, we thank you for these who will come and minister to us tonight. Anoint them with your Holy Spirit. Give them the words to speak. Anoint the chords that will come off these instruments tonight, the notes, the words of the songs. Father, we don't want any glory or anything that's going to take place here tonight. We want it to go to the only one who's worthy of it, to Jesus Christ. We praise you tonight. We give you honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you give a warm welcome to the Ted Jordan Band?
Farthest this evening, huh? Turlock, I see some hands. Sanger? Fresno? Uh-huh. I hope we got a couple little pieces here. If we don't, you better put some hard. Yeah, come on. Come on, let's get the joy of the Lord going here this evening. Come on.
Thank you.
all it's all about. He's the one changing, rearranging, makes the champagne shout. He's the king of the fiddlers, and I'm gonna praise his name. Okay, we're going to start the train up now. We want you to help us. It might get a little funky at first, but it'll be going, okay? So. Come on, put your hands together now. Thank you. better wind it no more than hell and you. My own special.
When you're getting on, say with me, come on. Heaven bound special. Let's all say it again.
Rated G for glorious.
If I don't have you, if I don't have you.